This conference will now be recorded.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Sandhya Nagarajan from Catnip Infotech Private Limited. So I will start over to explain you guys about how exactly we vary the storage networks in the industry domain. So initially, let's get this talk clear. So concentrate better, going ahead. Okay. So initially, we have three types of storage variations. The first would be DAS, D-A-S. And how exactly DAS will work is what I'm going to tell you. DAS is direct attached storage. So storage which is directly attached to the cable, computer processor, and the system is how the connection basically works between DAS. So it helps the I/O requests access device directly. So you don't have to have an intermediate connection to basically help out for the I/O connection request to be done. So DAS basically helps out to do this process of I/O request connections directly with connection between the processor and the computer system alone. So DAS is used because it can be highly optimized for a single user, and it is isolated processor with a very less initial cost. So this is the purpose of using DAS. Going on, we have SAN. Okay, here. So SAN, storage area network. Storage resides on a dedicated network. Here, when you talk about SAN, SAN is basically a dedicated network storage. So here we have all the storage which is shared over a network and through the channel, fiber channel. Okay, so we can have the input output messages or request which basically goes ahead only with the fiber connection that is helping out between the processor and the device, actual device. So today, SAN is the mostly used type of storage variation in the industry level because it has good performance and good scalability, and it also has a major high-speed fiber channel medium which is supporting for a very less traffic, because this is not over the network, this is the storage over the network, but the process of the request sent will be through the fiber channel, because of which the proper, you know, traffic will be managed properly, because of which the performance is increased. And here we can use the storage as a central shared point. So we can localize the storage into one particular thing, and the rest of all the devices which are connected to the same network can access the storage. That's how the SAN works. And so this is one of the types where we have the good utilization done. So most of the enterprise level industries would be using SAN as a storage variation. Next on, we have NAS. So what is NAS? NAS is network attached storage. So it is usually integrated processor plus the disk storage, which is attached to the network level of TCP/IP base. So here we have the file sharing or the file access happens over the network. So this is used by a small or a medium sized business, where the file sharing is one of the main important way of exchange of the information of the storage system between the management systems in their atmosphere. And this also can be scaled with respect to the storage capacity according to the user's demand. So this is also an applicable method of storage. Still, this is preferred very less than SAN. Why? It's because of the network storage matter, the network traffic basically matters. So here, since we have a storage kept on the TCP/IP based network protocol, the exchange of the, you know, storage from one system to the computer basically depends on the network speed also. So there might be a loss of data, or there might be a delay in the data processing. That is one of the reasons why most of the institutions will go for NAS, but still an applicable process. As we tell, not all technologies would be serving for all the problems. So it should be optimized according to the problems what an industry would be having, because of which we can see which type of
storage variation is required for which institution, according to which we can implement it. So from giving you guys the compare, so why we basically consider these three key factors for installing any of the storage variation in a company. So we have to approach any of the IT guys, and we have to basically ask how exactly their storage variation should be there, for which we have to understand these three terminologies. So let me explain that. Initially, we have to ask what type of a connectivity they are looking for. Is it like a DAS connectivity, which would be like a direct connectivity between a system and the processor? Secondly, is it like a network connectivity, which they are looking for scaling up their storage over a network? So that explains connectivity. The second point would be about media. So media is the type of the medium which they would be preferring for the exchange of data between the processor and the storage. So is it like an Ethernet, which basically helps for 10 Mbps to 1 gigabytes per second over the TCP/IP protocol network for the exchange of data? Or is it fiber channel, which basically helps for 100 Mbps to 200 Mbps of the data exchange? It might also be another way, which is SCSI. SCSI also helps from 400 Mbps, which is ultra SCSI, 80 Mbps, which is ultra true SCSI, and 160 Mbps, which is ultra 160 SCSI. So this basically supports the SCSI is one of the medium of exchange of data between the processor and storage, which basically helps only for like 25 meters approximately. So we have to ask which is the type of the medium that they would be preferably using. The next comes IO protocol. So the input-output protocol, it is also something which basically helps for the medium of exchange of data between the processor and the storage. So SCSI is one of the block-level I/O protocol that helps for the storage to basically, you know, give the I/O protocol requests between the block-level storage. And we have NFS, which is Network File System. This network file system is a protocol which helps in potentially sharing the data in the file level. And we also have TIFS, Common Internet File System. This helps for the file level, also the block level storage of exchange. So these are the three things which anybody should make sure of when you're installing a different variation of storage for any company. Next. So having said that, let's go to the comparison, how exactly DAS, SAN, and the NAS varies. So DAS is basically a network, not based. So it can just have like a direct connection. It doesn't require a network to have an underlay. But when SAN requires the network connection happening between. And NAS also depends on the network connection. So the medium of exchange would be using the fiber channels or SCSI or SSA for DAS, whereas when it comes to SAN, the fiber channel exchange is most commonly using the fiber channel is the most common way of exchange of the data using Ethernet. And NAS, it totally depends on the network. So Ethernet comes into the picture for the media of exchange. Then when it comes to the IO protocol, DAS is based on SCSI, SAN is also based on SCSI. NAS is based on the file system exchange of the data, which is NFS and TIFS. We have a bandwidth exchange, so variation also. So when you use DAS, it is 40 Mbps to 160 Mbps, depending on how much media it is basically in exchange. When it comes to SAN, it is from 100 Mbps fiber channel with 200 Mbps expected. It is increased now. So this was a recorded session when it was first 2001. So the data curated from then, it might be extended now. We have NAS. NAS, which varies from 110 Mbps to 1 gigabyte per second. So this is how the bandwidth also varies. And here, capacity sharing. So the DAS involves in manual completely. And the capacity sharing is there in SAN and also the NAS. It can be varied according to the user demand in NAS. And in data sharing, so basically, it reduces the soft. It basically, SAN here requires a different software, which is called Synergy. Synergy is a combination of SAN and it is basically developed by IBM, which provides a NAS-like file sharing with the data sent over the SAN rather than using a DAN for the performance, better performance. So that is one of the technologies, software technologies, which is used in SAND for the data sharing, where it basically helps in the data exchange with respect to the SAND model, not in the terms of the LAN. If it is exchange over the LAN, the network would be the major issue. So to increase the performance, they are, you know, exchanging the data sent over the SAN model. So this is the comparison between DAS, SAN, and NAN. Going on. So why really do I have to use SAN only? So giving you the answer for this, we have certain points which we are supposed to be discussing under this. So SAN basically has a better access. So when you tell access, you have a longer distance between the processor and storage, and high availability is also improved. So fiber channel is something which is used for the exchange of medium. Also, a large processor can be connected, same storage device compared to the typical built-in device attached facility. So access point, we have SAN, which is performing better. And when you come about the protection part, when you see with respect to the protection, LAN-free backups can basically occur using the SAN. So it doesn't depend on the network because of which the protection is also considered to be a main point, which is achieved in SAN. So it can be scaled by that way. And consolidation, when you talk about consolidation, the SAN is an ultimate scalable, you know, software. So this basically helps to ultimate store, you know, scalability. So storage on SAN can be managed from single point of control also. So it controls over the host and can also see if the storage is pretty good. Okay. So when you talk about data sharing, the data sharing is noted earlier, often benefits such as reducing the number of the file of copies. So it reduces out the duplicates which are there inside it and increasing the accessibility to the current data, reducing the need for the copy of data between the servers over the network. So it doesn't have multiple data of copies, which basically creates a great chaos. So it gives appropriate data sharing, and this can be achieved using SAN. So next would be, why perfectly NAS? Okay, so when you talk about NAS, you can talk about backup as a main point. So most of the SAN appliances in the market includes a snapshot backup facility, which is been introduced still by IBM. So this is one of the new technologies using a snapshot backup facility. And performance is also better when you are talking about NAS. So also file sharing. NAS provides a file sharing in the format as discussed earlier with same like synergy. So SAN can do well than NAS, but still file-like sharing is one of the types of method which basically helps out to have an easy access for the storage in NAS model. And we have another point, which is resource pooling. NAS allows the capacity within the uplines to be pooled. So resource pooling is also one of the main talk in NAS. And moreover, it is easy for the installation process. And also considering NAS has a NAS installation is costlier than the SAN is basically costlier because of the fiber channel which is used is pretty costlier there. Also, the performance is comparatively faster when it is coming to the NAS. So most of the organizations would still prefer NAS as a model of installation for storage. Going on for the next, what is iSCSI? So clear picture about iSCSI. iSCSI is a mapping between the SCSI IP protocol to the TCP IP protocol. So SAN and DAS are here the connection alternatives, while NAS is just a device. So when you talk about iSCSI, briefing out with respect to the same, so connectivity where iSCSI can be used for DAS and SAN connection of devices only. So or a LAN dedicated to the storage. So iSCSI, we have the cost also, which is considered to be pretty less over the installation. Costs are difficult to basically generalize, like we depend on the particular product. And iSCSI scan is the iSCSI SAN is likely considered to be lesser cost than the fiber channel, because of which we can use the iSCSI protocol, but still behaves similar to the fiber channel exchange of medium. So this can be helped over that point. and performance. In the performance wise, comparatively, we can tell this performs similar to that of the good bandwidths, just like fiber channels. Fiber channels can be scaled, but then performance wise, we can also count on I2C. And we have better management of the direct attached SCSI devices. So we have I2C connected disk volumes are visible to the attached processes. So the backup of the data is done through the method called SCSI attached volumes. So here we have a good backup facility also. And we have better file sharing. And also we have an IO protocol. The I2C uses the SCSI IO protocol only. So therefore it is like a block IO oriented, like just like in DAS and SAN, rather than the IO protocol, like in NAS appliance. So these are the main points that we have to dig when we are talking about I2C, which is also an important talk. So over to Antony, sir, for the next talk about the data center and components to explain. Thank you.
Yeah, while coming to data center, is the entire department enterprise of to maintain all the backend information technology system and data store. For going data center infrastructure, we have to assume first location and space and everything, assume the data center and how many racks and servers switching going to come. First of all, we have to analyze the infrastructure completely. After that, what is in hardware part, server, storage, switches, and everything have to assume, and cabling also. We have to assume all this. When coming to the electrical equipment, like we have to be like backup generator and UPS, there should be a online UPS, it should be there, it should be everything run in a battery, whether it is power having or not. And ATS switch is a must, it's a automatic transmit switch and PDU. And the main thing we have to consider in data center is air conditioner. We have to assume the facility of the inlet and outlet air, everything. The main thing we have to should not put centralized AC for a bigger data center, because the humidity will not maintain in a centralized AC. There is a PAC, it's a precision air conditioner unit, because it will run, the AC will come under, it will come under the floor and it will go top of the ceiling. It will be default design like that, so that it's better. We can air condition, we can go for a PAC. And while in data center, we have to consider the cabling part should be, must be neatly dressed and addressed, and it should be properly addressed to find out if any problem happens, it should be in proper format. And the additional components we have to see means it's like there should be a we have to see the temperature unit, and then water leakage system and the fire extinguisher. There should be not normal that extinguisher should not use, because in data center the all the equipments are highly, the data is very very highly unsecurable. There is a FM 200 gas. What is the this gas specification? Because if any fire or anything comes, this gas will automatically release. It will reduce the inherent of the oxygen level, so that the fire will not so that if this gas costs more than 2 lakhs one cylinder itself, so that the thing based on the importance of the data center, this FM 200 gas will come, not in all the data center. And the humidity range have to maintain it to 40 to 60%, and we have to see that remaining accessories like access control and CCTV, all these things are additional stuff we have to consider. When coming to rack side, we have to see the server storage and core switch and IS internet service provider equipment and patch panel, all the storage equipments we have to consider in the data center. And that completely dressing should be dressing and attend should be perfect. These all the things while considering to a data center, we have to assume all those things. Thank you. Yes.